Hey guys, John Garofano from Strength is Life. I'm shooting this video today to help you guys out with a method I have as far as counting your macros. I know there's this big, huge movement about, you know, if something fits your macros, if it fits your macros. And when I say macros, I mean carbs, protein, fat. And regardless of whatever your macros are, I really highly recommend a very important tool, and that is this. It is a digital scale. What it does is you put your food on it, and you turn the power button on, and you're able to weigh your food. What I recommend to my clients is that they get a digital scale. I don't like the manual scales, just simply because it's more convenient and more accurate to have a digital scale. And what I recommend is that you weigh everything. And people are, you know, when I say that, they mean, oh, that means, do I have to weigh my vegetables? Yes, weigh everything. Weigh everything. Because you'll notice when you go to take your, as an example, oatmeal, right? So you take your bowl of oatmeal, and you go to weigh out your half a cup of oatmeal or a cup of oatmeal, and you take that and you pour it into, you know, a bowl, you know, you think you're getting an actual cup, but if you weighed it out, if you actually put your bowl on this, and what's a cool feature with this is when you put the bowl on here, you hit the zero button, so it zeros out the bowl, which means anything in that bowl is now zero in terms of weight. So anything you add to it, you're only weighing the contents of what you put in that bowl, not the actual contents and the bowl. So basically, you put the bowl on, hit zero, bam, whatever you put in it is now going to be weighed. And the cool thing is that you can determine how much you're taking in of a specific food. Now, you'll notice if you take that half cup of oatmeal and you zero out the bowl and you take the half cup and you pour it in, you're going to notice something. It is more, typically, in my experience, more, that's maybe I use big scoops, I suppose, or heaping scoops, it is more than the serving suggestion on the package of your oatmeal, which will say, you know, it's 40 grams for a half cup. You'll notice you might have 50 or 55 grams. And people are like, well, you're just splitting hairs. Not if you really want to be successful. Because the people who are the most successful at bodybuilding are the people that are precise and accurate. So that means counting things by the gram level. With that being said, if you're in your off season and, you know, you have a little bit of flexibility because you're typically, you know, you're typically going for a caloric surplus. So if you're off a little bit, that's okay. It's not the end of the world. The worst thing that's going to happen is you're going to gain a little bit more fat if you eat too much, or you're not going to gain anything if you're not eating enough. With that being said, if you really want to be a pro and you want to be as accurate as possible, then I suggest you weigh everything, which includes your vegetables, which includes your protein. I always recommend that you measure your protein cooked after all the water contents are gone, okay? Measure it cooked. Measure your grains. There's a couple of different ways. Typically with oatmeal, I recommend that with oatmeal, you measure it uncooked, because it's a lot easier to measure that way. With things like brown rice, I recommend that you measure that cooked. Sweet potatoes, measure it cooked. And, you know, if you're going to remove the skin and then measure it, because it's going to be a different amount with the skin, so you could actually be taking under what you need. These are just little tips and tricks that I've learned along the way. When it comes to adding olive oil, you can just use a tablespoon. I mean, that's fine. You can measure it as well. You know, you can even use one of these to measure your supplements with. In fact, you should, especially if you're taking one of those products that says that's a proprietary blend, because you want to make sure that you're actually taking in the amount that the serving size has on it. So I'll do some more videos about this kind of stuff later on, but I just want to focus on this for a second. This is your tool. This is what I think everybody should have. Get a digital scale, weigh your food, and be precise. Raise the bar.